Hello, Milmac viewers. I'm with Andrew Woodward, who is the senior manager from Bell, who is responsible for Poland. Hello, how are you?
I'm good. How are you today?
I'm fine. Thank you very much. So, could you tell us about main goals which you like to reach in Poland with Bell?
Well, Bell is very interested in Poland. Poland has a very advanced rotorcraft market, and there are multiple needs for Bell aircraft here. Bell has been in business for 85 years. With the military and the commercial line. We've recently announced a sale to the Poland Police Department, the National Police Department, and we are working on possible answering Polish Ministry of Defense request for information on attack and utility helicopters. Bell makes the H-1 attack and utility variants that are also used by the United States Marine Corps.
So but also you provide those helicopters to the Czech Republic, aren't you?
Yes, we did just finalize a deal with the Czech Republic. They have purchased 12 H-1 helicopters. It is 8 Yankees and 4 Zulus, so 4 of the attack and 8 of the utility, and they are in action there. They are the third foreign military customer for the H-1. We also have Bahrain. The Kingdom of Bahrain bought some H-1s 2 years ago.
What is unique in offering those two types of helicopters together?
Those two helicopters are unique in that they are 85% identical. 85% of the parts, the systems, the drives, they are the same on both aircraft. So it makes maintenance much easier, it makes the supply chain much easier, and it makes the manufacturer a lot easier. If part of the line is slowing down, it doesn't really impact it that badly because 85% of the parts are common. So it makes for a more effective, more efficient solution for rotorcraft. One thing I might mention is pilots. If you are trained on one, you can also, you're trained on the other one because they're nearly identical. There's just a few slight differences, but it's a very economical and effective way to operate rotorcraft.
And could you tell us about possible cost savings which might be provided with such solution?
Well, you can imagine there's a lot of parts that go into maintaining these aircraft. But the same maintenance tools work on both aircraft. So instead of needing to buy two facilities, two sets of tooling, two sets of maintenance kits, you only need to buy one. Like I said, if you think of a container that you can pack many spare parts in, then it could follow the H-1s around, and that's all you need to maintain that aircraft will be in that cargo container for the next 30 days. So it's very economical and efficient.
Bell already provided some police aircrafts. Could you tell us what Bell could establish in Poland? I mean about the maintaining or servicing both police and military helicopters.
Well, obviously we would evaluate where the service and maintenance needs are. We know that Poland has a fantastic talent base as far as aircraft design and maintenance. So that would be part of an evaluation process to see where would be best in the market for Bell to be in order to keep our aircraft maintained not only in Poland but all of Central Europe.
And there's no secret you are present in Czech Republic,
yes.
But if Poland decide to expand the cooperation with Bell helicopters, is it possible to create something kind of Polish-Czech joint service center, Bell service center for this part of this region?
I think that would definitely be a very good idea, and certain people would be interested in hearing about that. Again, it's difficult to speculate on any specifics, but I think things you've outlined here have been discussed and thought about before, yes.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you for your time.
Thank you.